Hi everyone. The UI5 ecosystem has a new end-to-end testing framework. VDI5 replaces the now sunsetted UIVerify5 framework. VDI5, which is spelled WDI5 but pronounced VDI5, is open source and already available on NPM. It's a great community effort and there are a lot of great features already on the roadmap. Go check out Volker's blog post to learn more about it and test it.
Next week, SAP Conversational AI will come out with a new release. Here's three of the features. First, and most important, is speech-to-text. The web client now will have bridge APIs that let you hook up your own speech-to-text service into the chatbot. There'll be a GitHub project with guidance and code to help you set the whole thing up. Second, there's a new action to set the time zone for your conversation. You can get the time zone from the browser settings automatically, or you can go to a backend and determine the time zone. Setting the time zone makes it easier to set the language, as well as to understand date and time expressions like now and tomorrow. And third, if you're using a custom identity provider, you can propagate attributes from that identity provider and make them available within the user object for your scripting. I'll try to create blogs and tutorials for these and other recent features. You can get more information on all the new features in the What's New section on the Help Portal. And you can keep up to date by subscribing to the SAP Conversational AI newsletter and subscribing to all the SAP Conversational AI content within the community. All the links are in the description.
We decided it was time for another code challenge, so we've launched one for you this week. It's all about the SAP community in that it's a challenge that revolves around creating or enhancing a photo for your SAP community profile picture. Code challenges like this are designed to be just a fun way to learn more about certain topics. In this case, there's some Fiori there, some UI5 controls, Node.js based web applications, and really, depending on what you want to do, whatever you can think of. Head on over to the SAP Community Coffee Corner discussion area where there's a thread where you can find out more. Laura Schmitz and I will be hanging out there with lots of other folks as well, sharing ideas, thoughts, and what we've all been working on. There's also a link there to a blog post that explains more about the code challenge. See you in the Coffee Corner.
On the 10th of February, version 2.0 of the SAP Cloud SDK for JavaScript got released. Included are the generated client and the underlying open source libraries. Some highlights are the big core package got modularized into smaller packages so it is easier for your consumption. A new way of registering named destinations is included as well, which lets you register these destinations directly from within code. Also, a brand new samples repository is available to you. Get tested sample applications or different code samples showcasing functionality of the SAP Cloud SDK directly on GitHub. Upgrading to the new version is described in the detailed upgrading guide available on the official SAP Cloud SDK documentation website. Find out more on Frank Eisenberger's blog post in the SAP community.
There is a new customer engagement initiative regarding the SAP UI5 key user capabilities that you can sign up for. The key user capabilities allow you to change the user interface of your SAP Fiori apps directly inside the SAP Fiori Launchpad without having to write new code. And the team is looking for your help to enhance the existing functionalities so that key users can make UI changes for several use cases and connect those to several business roles. Make sure to check out Angelica's blog post in the description below to learn more about it and sign up for it.
SAP Data Intelligence Cloud Edition DI2113 will soon be available. And as always, one of the product managers, Eduardo Schmidhausen, is sharing the preview of new features with you. Here is the subjective, my list, of the top 5 features. First, improve data lineage. With the new release, you can extract lineage from structured data operators and as well from SQL views, including SAP HANA Cloud Data Lake IQ and non-SAP sources like Azure SQL and Redshift. 2. Drivers for MySQL and DB2 are already bundled in the iCloud, so no need to manually upload these drivers to user workspace anymore. 3. Ability to activate secure network communication for remote function calls, RFCs, when using ABAP connections to ABAP on-premise systems like ECC instances, in a secure way with encryption. 4. Increased flexibility to write into additional non-SAP cloud data warehouse solutions from SAP Data Intelligence using the new Cloud Table Producer Operator. And 5, custom solutions can now be downloaded via System Management UI in addition to traditional VCTL command line client. Please check Eduardo's blog post for the complete list of new and improved features.